Salud to the President of the Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela, the Honorable Nicolas Maduro, Minister Gladys Requena, the Vice President of the PASUV Party for Women, the Bicentennial Congress of the People, other honorable dignitaries, distinguished panelists, audiences, and my beloved international sisterhood. I am Reverend Tashale Sharia Moore Dickerson of the United States of America. And today I'm honored to be amplifying the voices of women in the struggle for equality, the Black Lives Matter movement, and the Afro-Indigenous communities abroad. I wish to express my gratitude to the organization that was hosting my visit to participate in the Venezuelan celebrations of this week. Regretfully, I was unable to travel because of COVID restrictions, but I want to give a shout out to the Movement for Peace and Life. Today, I will be uplifting the areas concerning women's empowerment and the revolution, and the necessity of this in the 21st century. Women and girls are the sustaining powers and stalwart pillars for the development of humanity. The roles, rights, and responsibilities of empowered women for social, economic, and educational development of all communities is of paramount importance. Women's empowerment is very important for the development of the entire society. It enhances both the quality and quantity of human resources available for every living being. Gender equality is crucial for the sustainable development of every country. Without women, sustainable development, socially or economically, cannot be achieved. There are many societies where gender inequality and the disparities are overwhelming. At the economic level, gender inequality must be addressed. We must have control over the resources such as property rights, voting rights, and the areas of reproductive justice. We should have access to participate in governmental affairs and be wholly supported as leaders across the universal spectrum. Let's discuss some ways how we can build awareness of healthcare disparities and social ills that disproportionately impact women, especially women of color. We need you to support and encourage women leaders to run and win public office. Develop capacities for social change that will empower women to transform their communities. Develop programming that will increase and promote heritage awareness. And through open discussion, community outreach, we can combat the stereotypes, double standards, and biases that are held against women. Also, we want to provide training opportunities for business and government and focus on uniting women of color across multicultural differences. It is my honor and privilege to work towards inclusion of more Afro and multicultural women in power. Having more Black and Brown women as keynote speakers and featured speakers in all factions. And I one day hope to meet the distinguished leader who is currently the first Afro woman in Venezuelan Congress. I close with a quote from one of the women activists and civil rights leaders that I admire. Some of you may have known her or may have know of her great achievements in education and that of the women's suffrage movement, especially in Venezuela. The late iconic powerhouse, Argelia Laya. She said, "We'll fight for our rights and those of our country because the problem of inequalities of women are the problems of liberation of all people." So I say, Viva la women revolution.